Hello, it's Kevin Bacon again, and I just thought I'd show you my latest projects from the lathe. We have here a set of wooden bowls and cups and saucers. These are designed for the playroom. There are three saucers. They are, I don't know, somewhere close to 4 inches in diameter, I think. And I profiled them all close to identical. They're made out of reclaimed oak, white oak. Then we have three cups. We have a baby bear and a mama bear and a papa bear, and they are made out of sycamore. And you can get a glimpse perhaps of some of that gorgeous grain that comes through from the sycamore. And also here where it's rough is because the wood is so difficult to get a finish on because it tears out so bad. These fibers are just horrible to work with. So it would take hours and hours to probably put a finish on there. Gonna go to the playroom. So I'm hoping that they're gonna get used and beat up, and so that's not gonna be so critical. Then the two bowls. This bowl turned out to be a little bit more dainty, a little bit smaller. And it's a standard small kitchen bowl size bowl. And then this one is a little bit heavier. And it's got the base rim around the bottom also. Very nice little bowls. Sycamore is not very heavy, so this is not a very heavy wood. Probably poplar weight. So not as light as balsa wood or some of the cedars, but not very heavy. And I think that they'll be very durable. They've been coated with acrylic, so they are pretty much waterproof. I wouldn't run them through the dishwasher or anything, but they should take whatever happens in the kids' room. And I made these for my 2-year-old granddaughter for her Christmas. So there they are. And now we'll move on to the next little project. And if you remember, I showed everybody a box of cherry that I got from my sister in the mail from our property up in Michigan. And I turned a piece of it into this lovely ink pen. It's a very pretty wood. It has very nice grain, but there's not a lot of contrast in this wood. And this particular piece has very straight grain. I didn't use any kind of a dye or a stain on it. And I didn't work my way up into the knots where we'll find perhaps some more interesting grain. This was mostly just to see how the wood works. It works very, very well. I was very happy with it. The finish is 10 coats on here. I put 10 coats of a shellac finish on here. It gives it a very nice luster. And there we go. So that is the first ink pen made from the cherry from the pines. Came out very nice. Very happy with that. So there we are for today. Thanks for watching. Kevin Bacon. Bye for now. Well, as usual, turned off the camera and realized there was one other project that we hadn't looked at yet, and that was the finished product of the spalted redbud vase. Now, give you an idea how big it is. It's about the same length as this ink pen. Not real big. These holes go all the way through to the inside. This hole goes all the way through and out the base. This hole goes all the way through and out the base. That hole goes all the way through and out the base. There's another hole there. And of course, there are pieces missing. There's a hole here that goes through to the inside. It's hollowed down on the inside. A little thicker than 1/4 of an inch, part of it, because I was afraid it would just fly apart. and I coated it with acrylic. And it just has so much character in that wood. It's just really something. And of course, this is redbud. I don't know, I haven't seen anybody else on YouTube working with redbud. It grows wild here in Missouri. It's almost like a weed. And this was a branch that had broken off it. I have a bunch more of it, so I'm going to work on it, work with it some more. Very happy with the way it turned out. See the crooked base. Lots of character. Lots of character. Well, once again, Ken Bacon. Bye for now.